carbon dioxide is the most important man-made greenhouse gas, and it is causing the planet to warm, and the continued buildup will cause it to warm even further. And there's real concerns about the potential for serious, dangerous climate change resulting from that. My name is Ralph Keeling. I work at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography at UC San Diego, and we're here in the carbon dioxide lab where we measure carbon dioxide concentrations and handle flasks. In this lab, we have equipment that dates back to the 1950s. At that time, the equipment was being put together by my father to measure carbon dioxide concentrations at stations from around the world on ships and airplanes. At the same time, he started making measurements with an analyzer on Mauna Loa. Keeling curve is this rising oscillation of carbon dioxide up and up. Each one of these wiggles is 1 year, and it's going up year to year, mainly because we're burning fossil fuels and releasing CO2 to the atmosphere that's building up in the global atmosphere. Earlier this month, we had the first daily reading at Mauna Loa that was over 400 parts per million. That's a symbolic milestone in concentration. One reason 400 ppm is significant is it's something that people can remember. And I'm in the business of measuring CO2 concentrations. I kind of know what it is every year. I know that it's changing. That's what I do. When my father started measuring in the late 50s, it was around 315 parts per million. And before there was any fossil fuel burning, in the middle of the 19th century, it was around 280 parts per million. And all the way into an ice age, it was lower. And we've gone in and out of ice ages now for something like 800,000 years. Carbon dioxide fluctuated between a much lower level and this lower level of 280, but it never was up as high as it is now. The consequences of climate change are going to be felt all over the world, and also right here in California. And some of those have already been noted. We have changes in spring snowpack, which is affecting water supply. There's likely a tendency for regions that are arid to become even more arid. There's shifts in what plants can grow where. There'll be shifts in what crops can go where. If you're growing wine, where's the right place to plant to have a vineyard in 20 years? Well, that's a different question now than it was a generation ago. But you can say, okay, carbon dioxide shouldn't matter because it's a trace component of the atmosphere, but you can choose the same argument to say, well, cholesterol shouldn't matter because it's a tiny component of your blood, right? Well, everyone knows that cholesterol matters, and it's not there very much, so small things can make a difference, and carbon dioxide has special properties that no other component that's more abundant than it has. Individual actions to reduce your energy footprint can help, but we need to go way beyond what an individual can do. We need infrastructure, we need policies that enable a large-scale retooling of our energy system. And the longer we wait to get on that path, the further we are into dangerous territory. So time is of the essence.